Hey Riff Raff, welcome back to the channel, I'm Ben. Today we're gonna hit the accelerator a bit with a guide on VR and Quest 3 that will allow you to enjoy more content and do many other things that are possible with Quest 3, whether you are using it in standalone or connected to a PC, thanks to SideQuest. I will tell you what is a SideQuest in a moment and give you a quick overview on how to use it. But first, there's something very important you need to do to make the most of SideQuest, and that's installing ADB drivers. Quest headsets are Android devices, much like smartphones. To connect them to PC and issue commands, you need special drivers known as, in fact, ADB drivers. To download ADB drivers for Quest 3, click on the link in the description or in the first comment, download the archive and save it to your desktop. After download it, extract the archive to a folder with the same name, navigate into the folder until you find a file with the .inf extension. If you don't see the file extension, it might be because the file extension view is disabled. To enable it, stay in the same folder, click on the View tab and check the File Name Extension box. Now you should see the file name with the .inf extension. Right-click on the file and click Install, then OK. If the notification for successful installation doesn't appear and you don't see any window to click, don't worry, the drivers should still be installed. If you don't see the install option when you right-click on the file, it might be because you're using Windows 11, which requires a slightly longer process, but pretty easy if you follow these steps. Open Control Panel, navigate to Hardware and Sound, then Device Manager. Click the Action tab, then Add the Legacy Hardware. Click Next, select Install the hardware manually choosing from a list, and click Next again. Click Disk Drive and navigate to the folder you extracted on your desktop. Click on the Android WinUSB.inf file, then Open, OK, and Next. Wait a moment for the installation to complete, and after that, the ADB drivers for Quest will be properly installed. Now, let's get back to our SideQuest guide. Open your web browser, type SideQuest into your search engine, and click on the first result. Click Get SideQuest. There are two installers. What interests us is the advanced installer. Select the installer for your operating system and start the download. In this video, I will show you how to install on Windows. Save the installer to your desk, and once the download is complete, run the installation by double-clicking the downloaded package. It's an automated installer, so just skip clicking Next until the installation is complete. Leave the box checked for Run SideQuest and click Close. This is the main interface of SideQuest. The red dot at the top indicates that the headset is not connected to the PC. So turn on your headset and connect it to the PC by using the cable. First time you may need to authorize the connection, so if required, put on the headset and authorize the connection between the device and the PC. After that, the dot should turn green, indicating a successful connection. Now, here's the exciting part. What can you do with SideQuest? First, this is the home screen, the main window where you can find apps and games, both free and paid, to install directly on the headset through sideloading. Remember that to find them in your library, you may need to search among unknown sources, as I am showing right now. This icon lets you go cable-free and even stream what you see in your headset to your PC, which is very useful if you want to show your friends the game you're playing or if you're a content creator. However, keep in mind that it's in beta and might not work for headset navigation, creating backups and more, so I always suggest to use the cable. This icon allows you to install APK files, which are the installation package for Android apps. This is useful for installing apps or games that are not listed in SideQuest. However, not all apps are compatible with Quest and VR, so be cautious about what you're installing your headset, as it could cause issues. The folder icon allows you to navigate the headset storage and potentially transfer files and folders to your PC. This icon displays a list of installed apps and games on the headset, including native ones, and allow you to backup files and saves. I consider the wrench icon a tool for content creators only. It contains commands that, if used incorrectly, can seriously compromise the headset functionality, even causing malfunctions or damage. So only tinker with this feature if you know what you're doing. Just know that it allows you to modify the headset internal settings, like the screen's refresh rate, sides bitrate, and frame rate for recordings made directly from the headset, maximum CPU and GPU usage, and more. For now, don't change anything, but let me know down in the comments if you would like a deeper explanation of these aspects of SideQuest with a detailed walkthrough of security settings. And finally, for the tech savvy, there's this icon. It allows you to write custom comments. This is where the installation of ADB drivers come into play, for the preview screen and this one. Through the ADB drivers, you can manually tell the headset what to do and how to do it. But of course, you need to know the right command to type in this field. And keep in mind that all commands will be reset when you restart the headset. I don't want to sound overly proud, but I believe this is the most comprehensive guide that anyone who asked me about SideQuest in recent days could hope for. So there you have it. For other requests, doubts, and if you want to thank me, I'll see you in the comments. You can support the channel by using the Super Thanks button or by using my Amazon links to purchase Quest 3 or anything else available on Amazon. Join the Telegram channel for a list of my meta games with a 25% discount. And before activating the headset, click on my meta referral link. So after activation, you will receive 30 euros credit in the store for purchasing games. Like, subscribe, and keep following. That's all from Ben. See you soon. Greetings, riffraff.